Because property values continue to decline and the needs of local government continue to rise, at least in their own minds, they want to raise the property tax rate in order to compensate for lower values. And what's interesting is that they don't call that a tax increase, because you may pay something relatively similar to what you paid the year before, but the rate will be higher. Now, in my book, when government takes a greater share of what you have, even though you may have less, that's still an increase in taxes. Also wanted to talk briefly, very briefly, about kind of the recent activities out there in the Gulf and where the needs are specifically in our community. As we know, the oil sheen and oil tarball streams are now less than 10 miles off the coast of Pensacola. So it will likely be next week that we see an impact, absent some sort of pretty dramatic change in circumstances. That impact won't be an oil slick like we see on CNN. It won't be, you know, huge globs of oil rolling up like we see in Louisiana. It'll be in the form of tar balls the size of your fist, or maybe even tar mats the size of one of these tables, or all of these tables, that are kind of floating out there in the Gulf. The tar mats, one of the most important things we need are coastline watchers. We need coastline watchers. Because the thing about a tar mat is that if it's spotted early, they're actually the easiest things to clean up, because you can get out there with the skimmers, get them out of the water, and it's so concentrated that you can actually be pretty productive in getting oil out of the water that way. The problem is that if those tar mats aren't identified, and they float out there for a while, or they roll in, and they collect sediment, and they sink, then they become tar ball generators for months or potentially years to come. So really, it's incumbent upon us be able to identify those. Have folks, you know, have your lifeguards know what the numbers are to call in if you see those tar mats or tar balls, so they can be cleaned up as quickly as possible. You know, in Tampa Bay, there was a very small oil spill not too long ago. And what happened was that tar mats would wash up on the shores. No one would report them. They would get covered in sand. And now, if you went out to the Tampa Bay beach and Safety Beach and started to dig, you could actually hit a tar mat from 1992 because it wasn't picked up promptly. So if we want to minimize the impact, there'll be some impact, but I don't think that it will kill our area. I really think we're more resilient than some of the prognosis indicates. If we can identify those early, that puts us in the best position. The second thing we need are boom watchers. We will start to see more and more boom systems deployed in the next 24 to 48 hours. A lot of people have been frustrated that not a lot of boom has been deployed yet. And the reason that not a lot of boom has been deployed yet is that we've learned lessons from those to our west. When you deploy the boom too early, it can be weathered, it can be stolen through either negligence or abject stupidity. Voters will run over the booms or cut them up in order to have passageways through them. And we need people that, if you live in a coastal area or you know folks that do, where they can see where the booms are deployed and kind of check up on them. That way, if they become displaced or they move around, we can get them re-anchored in the best position possible. So those are two things we need in the short term. In the long term, I'll tell you two of the big issues that Senator Gaetz and I are advocating. The first is tourism promotion. And I mean, Suzanne knows this as good as anyone I know, because her business, this condo's viability, depends on the ability to go out and market the Emerald Coast and market this as a drive-in destination. Well, $25 million was given by British Petroleum to market the Emerald Coast, specifically Northwest Florida. And it felt really good when the governor was here passing out checks. The problem is, the governor only released $5 million of the $25 million that was allocated, which means $20 million is still being held in reserve. Now, pardon my skepticism, but here's what I fear, that the governor is holding that for the winter season for South Florida. Because, see, you know, we think about the season in the context of this 90 days where we make all our money and rent everything out now, but really, if you look at Cedar Key, Naples, those areas in South Florida, they live on a winter season. And so I fear that the governor, instead of spending all this money in Memphis, Birmingham, Atlanta, Houston, our, you know, general destinations where people come here, I think a lot of that is being saved to spend later in New York, Chicago, Philadelphia to bring people to South Florida. So we are wise to that scheme, and every day we're hammering those guys to release as much of that as possible. And the governor doesn't work for us, doesn't always do what we say, we wish he did, but that's one project. The second project that we're really at work on is the claims handling process. Everyone seems to have a pretty bad claims handling story. Suzanne's got a pretty bad one where you go in and try to get your claim resolved by BP at one of the claim centers, and they send you on some journey through a bunch of documents to bring them. And it might be a different set of documents for person A than for person B, and that creates all kinds of havoc. We were on the phone yesterday with Attorney General Bill McCollum and former Attorney General Jim Smith, who's one of the top folks consulting and handling the claims process, who says there has to be consistency, there has to be transparency, and there has to be an ability for people in a condominium association to designate the association as the appropriate entity to go file their claim, or maybe even homeowners associations. That way, you're not able to kind of fragment our community and divide and conquer. That's not a productive way to solve this problem. So we have not gotten everything done we want to get done in terms of tourism promotion or claims handling, but know that we're laser focused on those two issues.